and welcome to NewsClick from my home. So today's conversation, in case you've been following our Olympic series, you know that we have dedicatedly been following this imaginary Olympics in a parallel universe. And we have covered every sport, every unique story that we have to tell you guys. You can read it again next year. The best thing about this is you can read it again next year aur waisa hi lagega aapko dekhne mein. To aaj humne ye bhi socha hai ki ek baat bhi ho jaye. और बात का विषय ये रहेगा कि हु इज द ग्रेटेस्ट ऑफ ऑल टाइम अमंग इंडियन ओलंपियंस. ऑन अ शो वी हैव शारदा उग्रा हु हैज परहैप्स कवर्ड मोर ओलंपिक्स देन ऑल ऑफ अस हैव सीन. लेस्ली जेवियर हु नोज एज मच अबाउट रेसलिंग एंड द ओलंपिक्स देन वेल आई डू. एंड जयदीप सर हु स्टार्टेड ऑफ दिस शो बाय सेइंग कि आई हैव नथिंग इन माई हेड बट ही हैज एवरीथिंग इन हिज हेड. आज के दिन पे आप कुछ भी पूछ ले जयदीप सर से वो धड़ाधड़ निकालेंगे. विकिपीडिया जयदीप सर से बात करती है. आई जस्ट वांट टू टेल यू. सो लेट मी स्टार्ट ऑफ बाय थ्रोइंग दिस ओपन एंड आई एम गोना गो टू जयदीप सर सिंस आप ही का हमने सबसे अच्छा इंट्रोडक्शन दिया है. तो जयदीप सर लाइक वी आर सेटिंग सम क्राइटेरिया डाउन हियर फॉर हु इज द ग्रेटेस्ट ओलंपियन ऑफ ऑल टाइम फॉर इंडिया. नाउ ऑब्वियसली देयर इज अ स्पोर्टिंग क्राइटेरिया, ऑब्वियसली देयर इज अ मेडिकल क्राइटेरिया, बट I feel like maybe you can tell us a little bit more as to what constitutes this idea of an Olympian itself, and then tell us like who you would bring into this conversation at all from India.
Well, I think how our choice is very limited. In ever since we started, it's now 100 years. I think we have started participating in the Olympic in 20. I think Sharda will be able to tell me. I think there was an Indian in the 1920 Antwerp Olympic also. So and 100 years we have won how many? 26 medals in all together, I think.
Sir, depends. So, like, do you count every hockey team member's gold? Like, तब तो फिर हैं 100 हो जाएंगे.
No, I'm talking about 26. Yeah, that is true. हो जाएंगे. So it is divided into two divisions. One is individual and one is team. And team is only one. That is hockey team. There is no other team sport we have won on all these years. So it can be divided into greatest Olympian. You can divide into two sections. One is team sports, another is individual sports. But all put together, both put together, in my mind, the greatest Olympian is certainly Dhyan Chand. Would you like me to explain, Vaibhav?
Please, sir. Absolutely. Like I feel like we have National Sports Day in this country, which is Major Dhyan Chand's birthday.
I think Dhyan Chand, because I have a great regard for people like, say, Abhinav Bindra, or for Leander Paes, or for Sushil Kumar. Of course, he has won back-to-back Olympic medals. But at the same time, when I think about the time of Dhyan Chand, India was not an independent country. It was a British colony. It's a colonial nation at that point of time. And we had no sporting history. Not even Test cricket started. Even Test cricket started in 1932. Before that, if Sekhar Naidu was a great player, then he was only known, mostly known at the domestic level. Outside India, not many people knew about him. It was like that. So at that point of time, and a completely faction-ridden team, in 1928, there was fight over who will be the captain. Your very own Jaipal Singh walked out in the middle of the tournament because all the...
He only left before the final.
Before the final, because allegedly he was not liked by the Anglo-Indian players. Same happened in 1932. The captain, who will be the captain? Lal Bukhari will be the captain. So Anglo-Indian players were not very unhappy. The managers had a fight with the players, what not. And against all odds, and there was no preparation, nothing. Nobody cared what's happening. There was no government who was pouring in money, like it happened in the case of Abhinav Bindra, or for Sushil Kumar, or for that matter, for Vijender Singh, or anybody you are talking about. So I think it's a huge achievement to take India, because sports and India did not go hand in hand at that point of time. Nobody knew what Indian sports was all about. And at that point of time, in a country which is under British rule, to score 35 goals in three tournaments and to win three gold medals at a stretch. And we have to mind one more thing, which is not, we talk about how Bradman lost 10 years of his cricket in between 1939 and 1947. We talk about how Lala Manatar, Vijay Marchant lost their cricket in 10 years. We don't talk about how Dhyan Chand lost his hockey. If we had 1940 and 1944 Olympics, perhaps he would have, I believe he announced his retirement at the age of 31. I believe he would have won another two Olympic gold medals.
This is where I have a problem. Major Dhyan Chand could have easily stopped the Second World War. Wo Hitler ko milne gaye the hockey stick ke saath. Phir bhi chhod ke aa gaye.
Kuch kiya kyun nahi?
Bilkul.
Oh, that's why, again, what I told you yesterday when we had a private conversation, Major Dhyan Chand was not an activist. Yes. He was a hockey player.
So this becomes interesting, because Shahada, now I'll come to you, because obviously when you come to, like, when you're talking just sport, it's very clear like who the great sporting gods of this country are. But if you'd asked me this question, who the greatest Olympian is, 8 months back, I would have probably had the same answer as Jaideep sir. There's no doubt in my mind. I mean, I've played hockey a little bit. Major Dhyan Chand ke naam pe hum bade hue hain. But in the last 8 months, there's something that's changed. As a sports journalist, as someone who's watching sports, you see things happening in this country. And you see that sportsmen are generally inert, not saying much. In fact, now I'm going to actually do a little bit of a fanboy moment and say ki aapne bahut acha piece likha hai about a really lovely footballer, Darren Caldera. And so you understand where I'm going with this, like what the impact of a sportsman should be in society also. Like, do you think, count that as like something, as a barometer for measuring this at all? Or is this like a different period of time we're talking about? So no.
I think that what happens with athletes is that we give them qualities that maybe they don't have. They are basically physically or psychologically, temperamentally capable of great feats in the sports that they play. And I think that the athlete that who then steps up and steps out of his little bubble of being an athlete is what you see as remarkable. Now, the thing is, they may not be great athletes per se, as in, they may not be massive achievers. They may not have actually what even Darren Caldera pointed out is that they don't have that much at stake. You know, the impact of the figure of Dhyan Chand and who he was and what he represented at that time to many, many Indians, many young people, young men, young women, and the fact that we won those medals there. But what you're saying is that, you know, when someone has to be a champion, then you would like them to be counted for more. Maybe this is what comes when you work for a long time, like both Jaideep and I have worked for Donkeys. But I'm glad that it's arrived at you so much earlier, the younger person. Congratulations. You learned important things very fast. So how unimportant is what we largely do in terms of our professional work, you know, in the wider scheme of things. You would want your champions to be champions outside their sphere as well. In India, the opposite happens. They become like, you know, slaves to power almost. I think when you do come across athletes that are different, you appreciate them. You appreciate, I mean, this is now going back to the Greeks and what to them represented what athletes and champions were. What did they stand for? It's not like, we don't have an account of any Olympian from the sort of the BC era, championing causes or freeing slaves or whatever. But you would want your current athlete to be in tune with what is happening around them and sort of take a stand. But now we've seen the stands they take, so your kind of expectations are lowered immediately, And you automatically think, okay, obviously they're going to join politics because they're talking like this. You know, you hear Babita Phogat, just her Twitter messages. And I remember meeting her when she had just won a Commonwealth Games medal, and she was this wonderful, bright-eyed teenager. And look at what she becomes. A lot of our athletes are fundamentally young people, and what they mature and grow into, that then tells you who they are as people, you know, when they grow up. I don't know if that's answered your question or I'm rambling. But
No, you have. Like, it also like brings me about like, so then that obviously the next question is, so who do you then rank? Like, you would have seen the growth of an athlete over the course of several Olympics, perhaps. someone, I don't know who it is, and this is actually going to be a surprise also. So who do you think, in your opinion, you've seen this like growth, even when you read about them and you think, yeah, okay, this guy or this girl can be considered one of the greatest Olympians?
I love recognizing the achievements of our athletes from the who are in the pre-professional era, because they worked with a lot of obstacles and a lot of limitations, whereas the athletes of today, like Jaideep is saying, that they are actually very spoiled in many ways. I want to just sort of literally play it safe and start making many categories. I think hockey should be made as an independent category by itself.
I know all you viewers must be looking at this and thinking, is Siddhant kahan par hai? Wo nahi hai yahan par, kyunki he said hum hockey pe alag video karenge. To humne usse bahar bhaga
diya. Theek hai, very good. So, and I would say, sort of, you know, the people of that time, you know, I would think Sriram Singh was a fantastic athlete. He competed in track and field. Physically, it's a much tougher sport. I am biased towards Abhinav Bindra because I saw his gold medal and I remember what it was like. What his gold medal did for Indian athletes, not for us who are doing, okay, proud feels ho gaya, hashtag, you know. But for athletes, what he did was a great thing. That it's literally like he set them free and says, boss, it's possible. It is possible. One more thing just to bring Jaideep back in. Jaideep, people around the world had heard of the great Gama before they had heard of Dhyan Chand. Leslie, am I correct or wrong?
Please. Yeah, you are right.
I actually literally have in my notes written great Gama.
But he wasn't a great Olympian.
So Sharda ne great Gama ki baat ki hai, that means that obviously she is going to bring, and she's talking about Sushil Kumar being the GOAT of Indian Olympics. And the thing is that when I thought that when Sharda is coming on, this is obviously hum mardon ki bahut badi ek galti hai, ki we automatically assume, and that's what the assumption I also made, ki oh yes, I hope like she will talk about a female Olympian. But why should she, when actually, if there is a female Olympian to be spoken about, she's from Kerala. And we have our spokesperson from Kerala, Mr. Leslie Xavier, who's going to tell us a little bit about how big an influence and what a big deal P.T. Usha is when it comes to the Olympics for India.
She attained cult status that way because everyone was looking up to it, the men as well, because here she was fighting a lot of odds to come up the way she was from the conditions that she was as a kid, and then at the same time also fighting through a system which never really promoted women in sport, and then with her performances, I mean the 84 fourth finish and later the high point of her career, the Asian Games multiple gold medal, and then the kind of impact that she had in the period that she competed, it continues even now, and the generation of athletes who look up to her as an inspiration, it continues even now. And then at her level as a coach, she's trying a bit, which is again a debatable thing, because as a coach I feel myself that he has not done great, but as an athlete her impact is beyond doubt. And so if you ask me to name an athlete who has had an impact in and can be considered as the greatest of Indian Olympics, I would look at people like Usha, people like Milkha Singh, Major Dhyan Chand as well, because he is an epitome of what sportsperson is. When we were growing up, we would be given examples of Milkha Singh and his work ethic. We will be given examples of Major Dhyan Chand at the higher level of game and skill and competitiveness that he brought onto the field by sheer hard work. All these were examples that we grew up. And of course, the never say die, never give up attitude that P.T. Usha embodied while doing whatever she did on the field. So I would mention these three athletes. I would look at people who have been examples for generations to follow, not just in their sport but across sport, who would be my greatest of all time. Yeah, I've given a general answer as such, but maybe later in the discussion I would pick someone specific. And
so the thing,
I would
so सो द थिंग इज दैट लाइक आप लोग तीनों ने तीन नाम एक एक दिया है आप लोगों ने.
मैंने तो चार पांच लिए.
तो फर्स्ट तो बेस्ट थिंग इज की लाइक जयदीप सर सेड स्ट्रेट एट द स्टार्ट, ठीक है, हमारे इतने कम ही है कि ये छोटा ही डिस्कशन हो सकता है. सो वी कैन एक्चुअली कट दिस राइट नाउ ऑल्सो एंड पीपल विल बी लाइक हाँ सही बात है. नो इमेजिन हैविंग दिस कॉन्वर्सेशन इन लाइक रशिया और द यूएस और समथिंग, हु इज द ग्रेटेस्ट ओलंपियन, पांच घंटे बात कर रहे हैं. पीटर जैक्सन विल डायरेक्ट अ ट्रिलॉजी, उसके बाद फिर वो एक और बनाएंगे, ऐसा हो सकता है. बट हमारा यहाँ पर तीन लाइक नाम आई हैव लाइक वेरी क्लियरली मार्क्ड आउट एंड इट सीम्स लाइक दीस थ्री पीपल आर द वंस हु विल यूनानिमसली परहैप्स लाइक कम अप टू द फ्रंट. एंड ईच वन ऑफ देम नाउ व्हेन आई लुक एट इट व्हेन वी से ग्रेटेस्ट ओलंपियन ऑफ ऑल टाइम देन वी स्टार्ट लाइक टॉकिंग अबाउट लेगेसी, राइट. एंड एज सून एज आई रीड देयर नेम्स आई एम लाइक देयर इज प्रॉब्लम. Each one of them, their legacies have been ruined by people in charge and people who have come after. How much of a role can a sportsperson play in defining their own legacy? This GOAT debate, this like, oh, greatest of all time, I have to now protect my legacy, build on my legacy. Like, is that like something that sportspersons, can they define? Is there something, any role they can play in this? Jareeb sir?
Yeah, they have, and the name, all the three names we have discussed so far, Danchit from me and Sharda spoke about Sushil Kumar and P.T. Usha, Leslie talked about. But if you come down to 36 Olympics, when Danchit was made the captain, he was like a role model to everyone. And the same legacies, when he became the captain, the team was really united. So he must have had that quality, which he carried till today. We still talk about Major Dhyanchand. Same can be said about Sushil, because in India we have seen when somebody win a Olympic medal, whether it's bronze or silver or gold, you can very well think that his career is as good as over, because he will come back. He will be getting a few crores from the state government. Then he will be given so much money, this much, and he will gather a few crores, and his career is almost over. Like we very unfortunately it happened with Vijay Kumar in London. He won a silver medal, and next Olympics he couldn't even qualify. So, but the greatest the achievement of Sushil Kumar is he not only won a bronze medal. First, he won a bronze medal, and in the next Olympics, he not only won another medal, but he bettered the medal. So he had so much in him. And 2008, he won a bronze medal, and 2008 in the World Championship, won a gold medal, and again a Russian wrestler in Moscow. And 2012, he almost, of course, he didn't win the gold, but he made the final. In 2008, he came through the repechage round, isn't it? But in 2012, he came straight to the final. And same with P.T. Usha. Because P.T. Usha, of course, except for 84, he didn't do didn't achieve too much in Olympics. But if you look at her career in the next 5 or 6 years, there was a time when she was the sole medal winner for India, even in Asian Games. At least there was one Asian Games where she won all the gold medal, and I think the Kabaddi team won another gold medal. So that way he carried the entire nation on his shoulders for not only in 84 Olympics, maybe I will say up to 1990. Leslie, what do you say?
Yeah, two Asian Games for sure. So that entire decade.
All these three. So were capable of carrying that legacy. So that's the reason they could be considered India's greatest Olympians.
I mean, if you ask me, legacy is a very abstract concept.
Very abstract value, yeah.
So we have hindsight about all the athletes that we have discussed right now. But then when discussions happen, we talk about their time and not talk about now, because legacy is measured in now. So I'm sure Dhyanchand's impact within the team dynamics pre-independent India was great, and he was a unifying factor within the team and all that. But I'm also, when I look back now and earlier the conversation that Vaibhav brought in about athletes standing up and expressing their opinions and their stance on social matters, on political matters, on injustices happening around across the country, which happens, by the way, abroad. And we were talking about US Olympians and all that, and we have studied, we have analyzed, we have praised a lot of US black athletes, Olympians who have stood up and faced the repercussions, even Jansen's and Jesse Owens, for instance. And so legacy for me is that continuation of whatever that is, and the interpretation that we can make in a later time and see if it is lasting. So lasting legacy wise, Dhyan Chand's great as a sports person. He has set an example, set the parameters for what an ideal sports person should aspire to become. That's why Dhyan Chand award is, I mean, the award is also named after him, and it's great. But the yardstick that he set also set this guideline saying that an ideal sports person would only play. His only concern should be the playing field and don't look beyond it. And he was a leader of men with impact at a time when India was going through a huge struggle for freedom. So his performances on the playing field great, and it brought out India as a sporting entity in the world. But at the same time, his impact and the impact that he could have made in the society, in the freedom movement, or in this immediate vicinity, immediate circle, I would say that he was happily being Sachin Tendulkar of the time. And there might have been many reasons for that. He must have been bound by the army code of conduct. He was a perfect soldier. So many factors. And it's not an attempt to belittle him. But then that tradition has continued after that. And that has continued and reached a stage where it's become a curse for Indian sport that way. And at a larger level, Indian society, where we have become inert, we are happily cocooned in our area of expertise. We have become, we focus on our world, our areas, and that's it. And nothing beyond that, because you are expected to do well in your area and don't bother anything about it. So Dhyan Chand's legacy is diluted a little that way, if you look at it, because, and I again say, I'm saying it with hindsight and saying it with subjectivity as well, because I see things, I see a sports person's role, I see a journalist's role, because we are sports journalists and we are expected to cover matches. That's the general drill that is in editorial meetings. That's what happens. You're saying that, sports page, last page, what will happen? Tell me, what is the lead? Who has scored a goal? Sachin Tendulkar has scored a century. Virat Kohli has done this, that done. No, but a larger impact within the society, in that sporting realm, is always there, always been there, because sport as an engine of social change is very evident. And
परेशानी है कि the while I agree that this is true, but like now I'm going to this is the bit where if you're Jharkhandi you got to tune in. Like I'll tell you, Jaipal Singh Munna hai, I consider him the greatest Olympian of all time. But the truth is that even in Jharkhand, the hockey stadium is named after Birsa Munda. The airport is named after Birsa Munda. The athletic stadium is named after Birsa Munda.
That's how I would say, na, because if a foreigner comes in, they would think that Jawaharlal Nehru or Rajiv Gandhi was the greatest athlete India ever produced, because all the stadiums are named after them.
That is true.
Indira Gandhi, yeah.
And so my point being that there is a reason that perhaps these great names who have come up in this discussion, there's a reason that they were exemplary on the sports field and then they're remembered for that, because they never raised their voices. Is that like, I don't know, again, like, I want to know if I'm right or wrong here. Is that why we remember them also, perhaps because they never pissed off the wrong people?
I mean, I just want to step in here. My connection is a bit unstable.
That's
so, right. Yeah, I agree with what Leslie said about legacy, you know, as to what it is. And yeah, they, our athletes are conventionally, they are always beholden to the state. They've always been. So I think the only sport in which people say what they feel fairly freely, relatively speaking, is football, where you're not beholden to the state. So you'll have CK Vinay doing something, you'll have Reno Anto doing something, you'll have Darren Scaldara saying whatever he wants, but not the big stars. You know, you won't know, Sunil Chhetri is not going to stand and start shouting about anti-CAA, falana and all that, you know. So it's all that balance that they're trying to do, like let's keep people happy. If you're looking for legacy with that context, it'll be very hard to find like a dream sports person. Okay. And I would suggest, and I'm not saying this because I know him well, Abhinav Bindra, because Bindra speaks for athletes. I'm saying at least speak for athletes. No, never mind the wider population, so speak for athletes. You know, call out your officials, call out the society, call out power. If it's your power, TK, it's a small sort of a word of power, but even that is not questioned. Mm. And if you're looking at athletic legacy or hockey legacy, what we can see is that after having these great figures like P.T. Usha, Indian athletics did not transform itself in any way. You know, it did not turn into something. It did not become what like shooting has become, that our shooters are everywhere or our chess players are everywhere. They're not winning medals, but they're there. You see their presence. You know, the shooters are making final. And everyone will say, oh, shooting is not a sport. You're only standing or lying down or whatever. But the point is, you have created that legacy of having more and more and more better people come after you. You know, they haven't won an Olympic gold, but they won silver. They will win a gold pretty soon. I mean, had the Tokyo Games happened, you gave yourself a good chance.
Yeah, good chance.
Yeah, the depth, your depth of field increased so much. And you can say, okay, that's also a legacy caused by whatever, whether it was Rathore's first medal or whether it was Anjali making the final in Sydney or whatever. So you had the knock-on effect. You don't see the knock-on effect in athletics. It's very sporadic. And in hockey, though, it's like the players are fighting, you know, that hockey has these sagas that go on endlessly. So what I'm saying is, you know, that sort of knock-on effect and the domino effect of having produced a great athlete. You know, I was doing something for doing a little bit of writing, trying to find out about Usha. Does anyone know how many international medals she won? Number? Does anyone have the number? I'm asking all of you. It doesn't mean like big medals. Medals won at races in some in the Olympics, somewhere in the US, a college.
Yeah, I just read the numbers somewhere. It was quite staggering, but I don't remember the
105.
Yeah. I read it somewhere.
105. Can you imagine Bhima Das would have won 105 medals?
Yeah,
or anybody else would have 100. How can you take an athlete of that quality and then we are crying to look for for a place in an Olympic final? I mean, look at the 400 meter. This is my theory, my pet theory, which I will now espouse.
Yes.
400 meter women's relay team. It has been our strongest team performance in an Asian Games without, they turn up and they win gold medal. You know, that kind of, whatever everyone will say, dope or whatever, I don't care. So, you should take those four people and that event and make that your own. Try and own it at an Olympic level. Try and say we'll go beyond an Asian Games gold medal and do something else. You know, Leslie's laughing.
Leslie's laughing. So, Leslie's laughing. You brought up dope. Okay.
Let me just clear that, because it's connected to Usha also, the 4x400 and the failure of 4x400, because Usha is big time into politicking and pushing one of her athletes into that quartet. Quartet is never set till the last day when they are supposed to run.
Seriously.
So how do you prepare? So that is where the legacy problem lies. And the other one about Usha that you mentioned, Jaydeep also said that we tend to celebrate that Usha was the only one who was winning medals for us. But we should have questioned it at that point, saying that why so?
Yes.
So legacy. That brings us to the entire ecosystem where everybody is inert. We as journalists are inert, athletes are inert, administrators are inert. They do whatever they want, we do whatever we want, and then we are not going anywhere.
This incredible story, the incredible 400 to 400 meter story, I must tell you, that in absence, I've been to only two Olympic Games. I've not been to like 8 or 10 order. Only two, but two pretty good ones. So,
Vienna place.
No. First silver medal, first gold medal. Dekhlo, boss. You cannot match that. Okay, so
Shada, then we are obliged to send you for another few,
obliged, yes.
Suniye, everyone watching this, ek hum log yahan par pass mein mere bottle hai, please donate. We are starting crowdfunding. We are sending Shada for gold medal to Tokyo Games.
Winter Olympics. Because crowdfunding reminds me of Winter Olympics.
Yeah.
For some reason.
Yeah.
Nice.
So this was the Athens Olympics. This was the semi-final, and they ran a fantastic race. The Indian women ran, I think Mandeep was the one who ran the ankle. Like, superb race, fantastic race. The finals held, they're there, they're competing, and Mandeep was not there. We don't know what happened. Nobody knows what happened. They have just changed the quartet that I think they broke the national record on both days. I could be wrong, but I know they broke it on the final day, which is still unbroken, by the way. And we finished 7th. And not 8th because the Greek team, which had lost their shoe. So we finished 7th. And that is the last, I think that's the last track final that Indians have ever competed in, if I'm not wrong. So the athletes, you should make statues out of them and put it somewhere. You should go and sort of talk. But they don't do that because, you know, you don't want an athlete becoming more powerful than Lalit Banot. You know, kya hai? What is the point?
But Shada, as a rule, like, we are anti-statue. So we are not going to make statues.
Okay. I agree. Okay, anti-statue. It's a good thing. It's a waste of money, actually.
Hai na? So, but this is a very important point you've raised, and I think it's like I would like to like just say that this societal legacy and all like side mein rakhte hain, yaar. Like just talk about sport, no? Sporting legacy ke baare mein to pehle baat
karenge. Yeah, perfect, perfect.
So, sporting legacy ke baare mein, like,
nobody for societal.
नहीं करना ही नहीं है, छोड़ देते हैं. Like our viewers are also bored. I am also bored. Like छोड़िए ना, नहीं करते.
ठीक है.
I'm saying. अगर आप स्पोर्टिंग एंगल से ही देख लें, एंड दिस इज वेयर लाइक नाउ अगेन लाइक एक्चुअली लाइक ऑल थ्री ऑफ यू विल हैव लाइक समथिंग टू टेल मी एटलीस्ट टीच मी. सुशील कुमार के बारे में बताइए प्लीज, उनका स्पोर्टिंग लेगेसी प्लीज. 2008, 2012, 2016, 2020
प्लीज बताइए. नहीं, सी ओवरस्टेइंग इज अ सिन इन एनी स्पोर्टिंग एंडेवर, एनी एंडेवर फॉर दैट मैटर, इवन इन जर्नलिज्म. सो यू कांट बी सेनाइल एंड देन राइटिंग पीसेस.
I'm telling
myself.
According to age, I think Jaydeep, you and then me. Either you or me, one of us.
No,
this is not about age. It's about writing ability. So this is a dig aimed at me, actually. But okay.
Yeah, let's take it reverse for a change. So Sushil's. I mean, so there is two ways to interpret it. So one is. Why is he trying to compete again? What is the reason? So one way to, I mean, if you are a Sushil supporter, you say that it's his innate drive, because that is the drive that we are praising when we say that bronze medal, say he did that alchemy act of making it silver and he wanted to make it gold and all that. But that, so the problem here is again the system around the athlete. We should give the athlete the right reality check as well, because athlete doesn't know. A boxer wouldn't know. Why would professional boxers go on getting into the ring and humiliating themselves and getting punched and then struggle to your life with Alzheimer's or whatever? Because they just don't know when to stop. And so you can't say because Ali was pummeled and destroyed by Larry Holmes, it's sporting legacy is dead because he overstayed in the ring, right? Sushil Kumar's stay, I know it's not comparable to Muhammad Ali or whatever, but it's at some level there are parallels because he doesn't know what to do, he doesn't know when to stop, and he thinks that he has it in him, but it's very evident from the Asian Games performance, very evident from the last World Championship that he's done, and he's trying to make inroads in a weight category which produces the best wrestlers in the world. At a given generation period, we have like 10 people who could win medals and who could destroy Sushil in 1 minute. So that's the quality that we are talking about. So it's not exactly Sushil's fault over there that he is overstaying and creating a problem for his legacy. But then as far as his sporting legacy is concerned, beyond doubt, we have won medals after that bronze medal in wrestling in every games that has been staged. And Sakshi Malik coming out and winning a medal, Bajrang being the world champion, world number one in his category, and 2-3 others who are contenders to win medal if and when Tokyo Olympics is staged. So that is his legacy, because being an insider in the sport, I know the mindset and I know the change in mindset that has happened because of Sushil and people, because how people look up to Sushil. So him trying to compete and staying, and I don't believe that his sporting legacy is tarnished. On a personal front, I feel sorry for him, in fact.
So, obviously, like, it's fairly clear that there are some very strong contenders who are undisputed when it comes to GOAT. This is end of part one for us, where we've spoken about the greatest Indian Olympian of all time. There's a part two also, which you can watch later, where we're going to talk about men and women who you perhaps not heard about, underdog stories, and some of the greatest underdog stories from the Olympics for India. Thank you.